So look at that. We just took a Viking down. You scumbags, another Viking down. Hello, everybody. Grace still plays, and we're back with more Kingdoms and Castles. No time for BS. So real quick, I said I had wanted to redo the kingdom for a couple reasons. Things were just a little bit too disorganized for even me, and that's saying something. One of the things I wanted was I wanted a nice, large, kind of open area to develop a main kingdom. And I think this is going to work pretty good. There's some areas with some decent fertility over here. There's a lot of barren areas too, but I think we'll be just fine. But the cool thing is that there's other little like peninsula over here and here and over here that we could develop like little secondary kingdoms in. And I think that would be cool. So we're going to go ahead and accept this real quick. And this is going to be the area for our main kingdom. So we're going to get moving along right away here. I'm going to put this, I think right over here looks good. We're going to have it facing this way, just because I feel like it. And things are good. We should move pretty quick here. I'm going to speed things up a little bit. And you guys had said that it wouldn't be that bad for me to just kind of like show you my choices and where I decided to move things. So that's kind of what I'm going to do. We're going to get all this crap chopped down. I want all this woods out of the way here. As long as there is some woodland nearby, we'll be able to make forestry centers. So it's not going to be a big deal or whatever they're called. I think they're called foresters, I'm pretty sure. Speaking of where I want to put the foresters, probably over here, because you can see there's a lot of like barren area over here. So we're not going to be using this for our fields. Our fields will probably be over here because there's a lot of decent land over here. There's some decent land over here as well, but there is a lot over here. So first things first, one of the things that I found was that I was using the roads kind of incorrectly. I was like connecting them to stuff. I don't think that's really the best way to use them. Instead, what I would do is I would surround things with them. And I got with the developer, and that helps a lot too. When you're trying to like build things and not have stuff get in the way. Like before, we had a lot of stuff where it wouldn't build all the way. And this is kind of why. So let's go ahead. We're going to just continue to make these roads right here. Go kind of quick, go right over here. And I'm making extra area here so that when we make new pieces of our castle, we can go and keep them all together. You know what I mean? Like all the military buildings can all stay together. So I'm going to keep about 2 tiles worth on both sides like this. And there we go. Okay, so that's the very beginning of the part that's going to essentially be our kingdom. Now from here, you know, we get to choose kind of where the road comes off of so we can start splitting stuff out because I do want the roads to connect. So let's split it off right here because this one is directly in the middle. And we'll put it right about here. And this is where we're going to start putting some housing. So let's go ahead and get that done as well. We'll put down a couple little hovels here. We'll have our hovels facing the roadway, as we often do. The other thing that's good about getting these hovels here is that it's all barren land. So it's not like it's a big deal, like there needs to be fields or anything right there. So now there's a couple things that we could do over here. If we wanted to, we could make an orchard over here. But like I said, I think we're just going to leave all this for just expansions from the castle. So everyone's kind of building this out here. Let's continue to get rid of some of these trees over here. I just want to get this stuff kind of out of the way for future expansion like this. All right, so we've just got a couple of pieces of farmland down. This was a pretty good area because we can put a windmill here and we can have farms all around it and they'll all be getting the benefit from the windmill, so it's no big deal. You can see I'm kind of expanding this way for the fields. Right around here is going to be an excellent area for expansion for housing and stuff like that because it's all barren land. So that's going to work out pretty good. I'm going to get rid of this last piece of forest. There's like one little piece of forest over here. Let's see now. From here, we should probably start getting ready to get some stone and things going. We do have this one piece of stone over here, which isn't bad. We also have a piece of stone way out here. We could really do either one, but I think we're going to go out this way. And plus, building out this way is good because there's a lot of area over here, if you notice, that we can do orchards in. This can all be orchard area. And that kind of region is totally fine for stuff like that because it's like when the when we get raided by Vikings, I don't consider that area to be like absolutely necessary. If they burn down the orchards, it's bad, but it's not as bad as if they get into the middle of the city and like start burning down hospitals and stuff is what I'm trying to say. So what I'm going to do is I've already built one road going out this way. We're going to do the same thing over here, and we're probably going to break off just like I did after two tiles and kind of continue to expand. Get them roads out, baby. There's no time like the future. And we'll kind of have them go... Let's see, how many out do I want to go? I think I'm going to go one... Let's see here. Yeah, let's go one more out in both directions, and then we're going to start wrapping around like this here. Now, again... We've got a lot of, like, really decent farm area over here. So, actually, you know what? I'm going to keep this one demolished for right now. We may even go out further on this side so we can utilize all this area. But over here, we are going to continue to expand kind of this way. And I'm going to probably do that right along here. All right, now that we have these roads out here, we can throw down our quarry. As it would be. We can put at least two down here. If I want to remove the road or move it, we can put down another one. I think I'm going to have it kind of like facing the road this way. And I think we'll probably end up putting a secondary one down. But for right now, one's going to be just fine because we need the people anyway. Now, again, right over here, we can start if we wanted to putting down like orchards and stuff. But fields are going to be just fine for the moment. It's not going to be a big issue because we're not going to have to worry about like getting a ton of more food until probably we get like, I don't know, maybe 20 people or so or 24. So once we get to that point, I'll just start making more fields around here and we'll be totally fine. Take that, Mother Nature. I don't have time for your crap. I want to get rid of all these trees anyway. Plus, we need the wood. So it's totally fine. Just kind of getting rid of all this. These advisors are going to be telling us stuff like we're starving and things like that. Oh, don't give me that BS. We got plenty of food. You can't lie to me, man. Every once in a while, we get a little bit low on food, but the peasants can stand it. If there's one thing that every peasant understands, it's starvation. I'm gonna throw down a well kind of in this back corner, and I'm probably gonna do the exact same thing in the other back corner once we have a couple more resources right here. I think we need a little bit more stone. Yeah, we do. So getting another quarry up will probably be pretty good. We're gonna need a couple more beds though. You really gotta watch about how quickly your people grow. The reason why I figured that out is just because you get Viking raids kind of fast if you grow your population like super quick, and that can be a real pain in the ass. So for right now, we'll just kind of keep it like it is. I may build two more hovels over here. We could also build one hovel over here and then like maybe like just something else over here. I haven't really decided yet what kind of way I want to make it, but for right now, this is kind of the direction that we're going. I think a cottage right here would be nice. We may even make one on both sides of this. This is going to get us some more people. And plus, this is just a really good residential area as well because there's a lot of barren area over here. So that's pretty good. We can also put a windmill over here if we really wanted to, but the food issue is a non-issue right now. This area right over here is pretty good for a granary, though. I'm thinking about putting it there. I'm going to throw the old granary down. Right about here looks good. And this is going to give us one extra area for a well, which is going to be pretty important because if there's one thing that we definitely need by our fields, it's going to be a well. Plus, as we build over here, this well is going to be able to get, like, if we decide to, like, build some more fields over here or something like that, it'll be able to keep all that area from burning to the ground as well. That's right, boys. Get that infrastructure down. Right over here is going to be our main foresting area. So right now, I'm just kind of getting all kinds of different roads down and stuff like that. So right now, we can go over to our economy and we can start throwing down some forestries, and we are gonna want quite a few. Let's see here. Let's put at least, let's do one and I would say two for right now. Now we're gonna need some extra men and that's fine. So what we'll probably do is like put down maybe a couple more hovels or something. Like I said, I think I might put like one hovel over here and one hovel over here. And these hovels are going to face this road, perhaps. We could also put one hovel over here and one hovel over here, and they'll kind of face this way. All right, we've got a fire, but we've got a couple of wells, so I was going to say, so it should be out pretty quick. But I was totally wrong. I may even build another well over here. In fact, why don't I do that right now? We're starting to get quite a few people in our little area here. Having overlap on the wells is never a bad thing. And the reason why is because the more places that they have to draw water from, the better. And let's see, wooden stones coming in pretty quick, so that's looking good. Go over here to the castle. We're gonna wanna think about getting a throne room fairly soon. Our beds are almost filled up, and this is the number that we kinda wanna stay at. So we're no longer a quiet hamlet, we're a small village now. We're gonna have to take that under consideration. I think that's right about when you're gonna start getting raids. So at that time, we're gonna wanna start thinking about putting up some walls. All right, and the throne room's gonna go down. I think I'm gonna put it, if I put it here, I may like use up a lot of this area, but I also might use this area for charcoal. So right now I'm gonna put it here just because it looks a little bit more like it makes sense if I put it there, you know what I mean? Like the fact that the door is kind of facing the same way and that it's more in the middle than like around the back or something like that. I don't know. Could have maybe faced the door this way as well. Either way, I don't think it's going to be a big issue. While I'm at it, I should probably fix this road right over here also. So let's go ahead and get that done. And we should probably have enough in a little bit here for a windmill. I'll probably put a windmill down here just so that we're producing all the more food. Our food is pretty good right now. It's not bad at all. They're so close to the granary that they can get all the food in before the winter, and it's helping out a lot. All right, man, throne room's down. We need to think about a stockpile now. And right over here is a pretty decent area for a stockpile. I think we'll go ahead and make it right about here, perhaps. We could also make a stockpile over here if we wanted to. Either one is fine. It's going to be right in the middle of both the wood and the stone, which is pretty good. And you can make it pretty much in any direction, but I think I'm going to go ahead and make it in this direction. We'll go ahead and put one there. And if we want to, we can put an identical stockpile on this side. Again, mostly barren land, so it's not like a really big deal. We don't really have too many idle people, so the other thing that we're going to want to think about is probably getting another one of these cottages. But before we do that, we're probably going to want to get enough gold to make some archer towers, because pretty soon we're going to be getting freaking raided. All right, man, stockpiles up. They're putting stuff down, looking good. The other thing that we can do is we can do like a little inverse. We can put a stockpile here and a stockpile over here, and we could put a cottage over here. This way it's almost like an inverse of either side. That might actually be pretty cool too. In fact, I think that's probably what we're gonna do. The reason why is so that there's a stockpile over here so that if we build stuff over here, they can utilize all the wood and stone and stuff from the stockpile instead of maybe having to walk all the way over to this one, for instance. All right, man, time to start getting some castle blocks down. We'll put them over here for right now. They're close to the water, but it's not really a big deal. We're probably gonna have like a couple of them going on. And what I mean by that is like there may be like some over here, and then we might put some over here, for instance, almost like a double layer. And we'll be probably doing the exact same thing over here. I'm just trying to decide if I want them out this way or out this way. I think I'm gonna have it out this way. All right, folks, so now at this point, hopefully that was like a little bit of everything. I just kind of like, you know, did my jump cuts and stuff like that just to show you kind of how I was making stuff. And now we're going to pick back up right along here. So what I'm going to do is I'm probably going to have my road going out this way just because it would be weird if like there wasn't a pathway going out here. I don't know. It just seems strange. So I am going to have kind of like a road go out this way. I am going to have a road go out this way. And this is like the very beginning vestiges of like our towers. I do want to get some over here as well, and I think we'll probably put some like here and here for the moment, and then eventually we're going to want some here and here. Now the only issue is that we just don't have enough dudes right now, so what we're going to do is we are going to put down another building, and we're going to see if I can get this done in time. Now we can also eventually look at all this, man. How big is this? I really want to know how big this is. Okay, good. So this can fit right in here if we want it to. Oh, man. Oh, yeah, that looks freaking sweet, too. I may put it right there. So that's going to be perfect. We can put this on either one of these sides, and it's not going to be a big deal. But for right now, let's start getting more people coming into our lands. So let's go ahead and make this face this way like this. And then we're going to want to put, like, a tavern and stuff down, too. We're also going to want to get one of those charcoal places down. So again, for the charcoal maker, like any place over here would be just fine. So for instance, we could put this right here since we're not really using a lot of area over here. And that'll work out pretty good. We'll put a charcoal place over there. That should get almost all of these buildings. It looks like the distance on the charcoal is very, very good. So it's not a big deal at all. This should be done pretty soon. You can see now that I have like these roads in a square formation instead of like trying to run the roads into things, everything gets built and there's no issue. I got to talk to the developer about that, and apparently that is the way to go. So there you have it. There's our sweet looking windmill right over there, looking freaking great. And now the big thing at this moment is happiness. So let's start worrying about things like a tavern and all there have you. A great place for a tavern. Would you put one right next to the castle? I don't know. We could also put one right over here. This would probably be a good place for a tavern too. Now, if we want to get all of the buildings though, we could put it down here. We could get almost all the buildings if we put a tavern right next to the freaking, right next to the castle. Is that normal? I don't know if that's normal. We could also put it right in these people's backyard if we wanted to. It's like apartments attached to a tavern. How you like that BS, guys? Let's see here. What is the distance on this? We could get quite a bit if we put like a tavern over here and then another tavern over here. But I'd really like to connect these roads. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to put it right here. I decided we're going to put one tavern here and we'll probably extend a tavern over here because I do want to use all this available space. Well, most of it. So we'll put another tavern over there when the time comes. You can see we have a couple of idle people. And right now is when I probably want to start thinking about making freaking archer towers. Now, the only thing is that it takes people to man the archer towers. So that's going to cost us men. I think it's 2 men per archer tower or something like that. But we need the defenses. Man the archer towers, you folks. Protect the village. And it'll be good anyway. The only issue is if we get attacked from this region, we're going to be a little bit vulnerable. Well, a little bit vulnerable. We're going to be real vulnerable. Something I might want to think about in that instance is... Oh, here you go. Okay. So the Vikings are raiding. Where are they coming from? Of course, they're coming from this side. It's not a huge deal. The very first Viking raids just aren't that bad. Like, they're going to come in and they're probably going to, like, destroy some of our stuff. But I'm not super worried about it. In fact, what I might want to do... what don't we have right now? Okay, there we go. I might want to put a well down right over here, and I think I'm going to. Just so that we have more available water in case we need it. Ooh, we've got an archer tower down over here. The big issue is we don't have anyone really to man it. I think what I'm going to do is shut this down for now. I may even shut this one down for now. And see if I can get everyone manning the towers. So let's see what happens over here. Are you guys going to set my freaking fields on fire? I'll bet you are. Oh, they're setting the granary on fire. Freaking figures. Put that out, boys. Put it out if you can. Put it out if you can. Oh, and they couldn't. That's awesome. All right. Well, like I said, it's not a huge deal. We're going to clean this right up. Oh, well. I could build another granary. Oh, you Vikings are going to get yours, though. Just you freaking wait. Oh, just you wait, you dirty bastards. Oh, I can't wait. We do have 2 towers down now, both with 2 people. But the big thing is we're going to have to get our men back. I'm going to keep these quarries kind of offline for the moment because it's not a big deal. And I think the next thing that we are going to do is put some archer towers down over here. You don't need to put them as close as I'm making them, but I like to do it because it looks like, you know what I mean? It looks like there's going to be a road and a gatehouse and stuff like that. Like you could space them quite a bit if you really wanted to, but it does take a lot of resources. So I'm just going to kind of leave it where it is for the moment. And let's go ahead and build down 2 more archer towers. Just cleaning up a couple trees here. I'm going to see if I can get a couple of trees down so that we can get kind of working on our archer towers on this side. We're going to need a lot more wood though. As a matter of fact, the very second I can, I'm probably going to go ahead and get another forester. And let's move up here a little bit. We're probably going to be getting another raid pretty soon. So I'm going to want this done fairly quickly. Our happiness isn't great right now. Put another forestry right there. Actually, you know what? I don't want to put it there. I'm going to put it over here. That's what I want to do. Let's put that over there. I think we get our materials back when we do that, so it's not like it's really like a waste or anything. Yes, let's put it there. There we go. Insufficient resources, you say? Poppycock! Get that crap down. Plus, we've got a bunch of wood just laying around over here, so they are putting this granary together, which is good. Time to connect these roads, too, because I haven't done it yet. So let's go ahead and get this stuff all interconnected like that. There we go. That's going to be a little bit better. It's just going to look a little bit more normal too. I can probably connect these roads as well if I want to, which we might do. Let's see how we're doing over here. Is the granary almost done? I do believe it is. And hey, there we go. Okay, good. So now, 7 people visited, but 4 decided they wanted to join. 4's quite a bit, man. That's not bad. Let's start getting more castle blocks down, though. Castle block over here. castle block over here for the moment. And like I said, the archer towers, we can move those however we wanted to. So if we want to go ahead and like destroy these eventually, it's not a big deal. We have got quite a few pieces of gold right now as well. So I do kind of enjoy that. I'm going to get a road going this way as well so that it does go at least through the middle of the towers there. We're going to put not drawbridges, but gates on all these as well. We're going to get that done in just a second. Yes, my minions. Yes, my plebeians. Go forth and make this stuff happy. Happiness is 66, so pretty average right now. But we still need a lot more things. We're going to need like a hospital and all kinds of stuff, but we're going to get that in all due time. First things first, though, we need to get some defenses up. And then eventually we'll worry about getting a, like, full walled settlement. Now, the full walls of the settlement are probably going to be back. They'll probably be, like back a notch all the way around for the most part. Like, they're going to go out to here. But from the sides, they'll probably be, like, one in almost, if you know what I'm saying. There may be little gaps and stuff just because of, like, where the housing structures are. But I'll worry about that when we get there. For right now, let's just go ahead and kind of move things a little bit faster over here. How's the wood doing? Wood's doing okay. We got a couple of idle people. So let's go get another forester down right here. This way we can keep getting more and more freaking trees done. Okay, now we're getting to the point where we can get quite a few more archer towers. Oh, this is going to be good. We can eventually get that Chamber of War open too. That's not what I wanted. Let's go grab this archer tower and stick it on the top right there. And what else? Nah, I'm going to keep going with archer towers for right now. What do we need? A couple more trees. So we do have a few idle people. So one of the things that we could do is just kind of set some actions to chop all these trees down for right now. Oh, God. Destroy Mother Nature for me, my plebs. Get me all of those delicious trees. Look at these birds. Like, this is interesting. Is this bird landed or did he get caught in the tree? I'm pretty sure he got caught in the tree. That is exactly what happened there. Another archer tower right there. You can see the range, by the way, of these. So there is some overlap. Overlap is pretty good, though, because eventually you start getting ogres and stuff coming at you. And the ogres are no freaking joke. They will rip your namby-pamby ass apart if you let them. So just a thing to know. As a matter of fact, let me go ahead and get out of here. I may even make my next towers over here. The only reason why is because this giant black rock is in the way. So let's do that, as a matter of fact. Let's go ahead and make some castle blocks here and here. Because what we can do is this way we'll be able to extend a wall all the way out to here if we want to. And we can extend a wall all the way out to here. And then we can kind of like make some interconnections as things go on. It's not going to be a big deal. And it may not be like a perfect square, but I'm not really worried about that. The food issue, we could probably use some more food here soon. Our food stores are running low. Build a town square, festivals. Okay, and then Vikings. So we are going to have to deal with Vikings. The food thing, right about now is when we can probably start dealing with it. And I think I'm going to go ahead and make an orchard. And we have some really good property out here to make orchards, man. Like, we can make one right out here. And we can make one right out here if we want to. And both of these are going to be excellent places for orchards. So, as a matter of fact, let's go ahead and do that right now. Orchards are absolutely amazing when they're on, like, hyper-fertile land, like, right here. So, let's, yeah, I'm going to put this orchard right over here for right now. That'll be fine. And then if we want to, we can put like a granary here in the middle or even over here. There's one piece of barren land over here. It's not really going to matter too much. And even if we do this, we still have all this really fertile land to use should we need. So now we're getting there, though, baby. We've got quite a few archer towers down. Oh, you freaking Vikings. You have no idea. You have no idea how long I've waited for this crap. How long I've waited! Happiness 67. So we could probably do with another tavern as well. But I think that we're right about where I want my very first manor to come in. And I think right over here, or right over here even, could be a decent place for the manor. Or even over here, right next to all of these, like this could be like the guy's freaking fields, like the manor guy's plantation area, especially if we want to put a storage area over here. Wow, it takes 5 of 5 people for the storage. I never really noticed that. That is like a lot. We could also just put some more hovels down. That's totally fine as well. In fact, you know what? Let's just do hovels for right now. We'll grow a little bit slower. You know what? Instead of hovels, we can put down cottages. There we go. Cottage right over there. And we could probably put another cottage over here if we want to, and they'll all be fairly symmetrical. Plus, now it's going to look like a real-life neighborhood. I like the crossroads signpost. Look at that. Hold on. Let me see if I can back up enough to show you guys. Look at that. It shows you. It's like right over here to Viking Bait Way. Which is kind of what we have. We can still reserve this area for a manor as well if we want to. So we'll grow decently, but we're not going to grow like crazy willy-nilly right now. Ah! Oh, the Vikings are coming, are they? Okay. All right, and they're coming on this side. In fact, hold on. Let me go ahead and pause real quick. Reason why is because, let's see, we need 20 gold, huh? Okay. How quickly can we get a little bit of gold here? Can I get some gold? 19 gold? Oh, I don't think we're going to get it. Oh, come on, come on, come on. Yes, 20 gold. Okay. I wonder if we can get this down in time. I don't think we can, but I'm going to give it a shot anyway. Oh, right over here. There goes the Archer Tower. This is kind of why you want some overlap as well, because you'll do a lot more damage. Look at that. We just took a Viking down. You scumbags, another Viking down. Yes, you're not going to get my men that time. He tried to kidnap someone. Look at him, but he wasn't able to get it. He wasn't able to get him. Another man down. Excellent. Yes, get him, get him, get him, get him, get him. Get him. Get this scumbag. Get this scumbag. Oh, you want to run? Oh, if you run this way, you're going to get dual archer towered, baby. Dual archer towered. Take him down. Yes. Excellent. We got one more guy over here trying to get away. Yes. We killed them all. I think we lose our men, though, as long as they get them over the shoulder. But that was our very first successful Viking rappel. Look at the... Who's piloting this? Who's driving the pirate ship? There's no one left. Everyone has been slaughtered by the denizens of the Spoon Lickery. Hold on here. Or the Lickery Spoon? What was it? I can't remember. We'll change it every time. I could care less. The Lickery Spoon. There it is. We've got it going on now, boys. We are freaking set. We are set right now. We've got a good amount of wood production. We've got a good amount of, well, we can have a good amount of stone here in a little bit. Both these are still turned off. We've been working on just what stone we had. And you can see the stone goes a long way, man. But now we're going to have another section of archer towers. And we've got this building over here. The only issue is no one's super happy, but that's fine. Because we're going to put down a town square in just a little bit and start holding little festivals in there, have you? And we could put down another tavern as well. The biggest issue is that we're going to need people to man the tavern. But that should be just fine. Guys, I hope you're enjoying Kingdoms and Castles. The kingdom is looking much more normal now. And I think that we've got some pretty decent plans here for protection. I think we're going to do pretty damn good. We have a little bit of area for some expansion. We've got wells. We've got charcoal. Everyone's doing okay. As a matter of fact, if I click on this here, no one's in there right now, but they're being taxed with a, hey, they have road access. They have well access. They have the nearby tavern. So we're going to need more charcoal as well. So if we want to, we can probably put down another charcoal area over here, and that should give us enough charcoal for everyone. Until next time, folks, stay foxy and much love.